Hi everybody, my name is Lyndon, and in this video, we're going to do some quick signal distortion type of effect using a displacement map. So for this effect to work, you're going to need some stock footage or some kind of mat to use as the displacement map. So here, the screen glitch effect that I grabbed from YouTube is available on the link in the description, but you'll need to use a YouTube downloader to grab it. It's a very useful effect though, and there's lots of different ones. So if you can't get this specific one, you can literally just type in screen glitch or signal distortion stock footage in YouTube and grab something to use. Okay, so I'm gonna close that down, make a new comp, use 1920, 1080, 30fps, 150 frames, click OK. So for this, now I need some more text. Okay, so we got some text, and now we need to grab our displacement map, which is going to be this screen glitch. We'll just slap this either on the top or the bottom, doesn't matter. We do need to turn it off. And then you can do this on an adjustment layer, or you can do it directly on the layer you want to distort. Go to effects and presets, and we're looking for a displacement map effect. So grab that. And the displacement map right away is going to say, what layer do you want to use as the mat? And by default, it's going to assign it to itself, which isn't going to mean anything. So you need to have a separate layer that you're actually using to drive the displacement. So I'm going to switch that to screen glitch, and then on the source, do effects and masks, just in case if you add any effects to this layer here, you'd want them to also apply in the displacement map. So right away, if we just scrub through this, you can see there's a little bit of distortion there. And the way this works is by looking at this map, every frame is different. And based on the parameters you use for the horizontal displacement and vertical displacement, both the value and the actual channel, based on those values, it's going to shift the pixels in the alpha on the text layer in accordance to the parameters you have set. So you can change this from red to blue or luminance, hue, and based on those settings, it's going to distort the image. So something like for a signal loss, you'll want stock footage that changes every frame. Otherwise, it's not going to look accurate. It's not going to be fast enough. So if we just scrub through this, you can see this pretty continuous. Now, we wouldn't want this to be distorting for the entire time, and we probably want to increase the distortion. So maybe for a horizontal max distance, something around 50 might give us a better result, something that's a little bit more intense. And for vertical, you have to be a little bit careful, but you could go to whatever you want from this. But we could try something like that and then just animate these values. Okay, so I'm going to go forward to frame 15 around there, set a keyframe for the max horizontal displacement and max vertical displacement, maybe go forward 10 frames, and then set these both down to zero. Then maybe we go a few seconds here, and maybe it starts back up again. So if we set manual keyframes, then gradually allow the distortion to start up. Maybe 50, and then maybe 25 for the vertical. Let that go for about 10 frames or so, and then we'll stop that. Set that back down to zero. And you'll just have to play around with what looks right. This might be a little bit too slow, or maybe it's too fast, or that's for you to decide. Let's see what we've got here. So maybe we want like another little bit of distortion around here, so we can just quickly set in some more keyframes, have that start distorting quite quickly. And you can just put in random values for these. Give this a little bit more space. You can also copy these keyframes over. So let's play this. So quite a lot of distortion, then a little bit more. So something like that. So to make this even more interesting, let's make this text layer 3D and then have it fly in from behind the camera. So really simple to do. Select that layer, click the 3D switch, and then at the beginning, click the P key, and then we'll set a value here to be like around negative 3000. So it's now behind the camera. Enable the position and come forward, reframe 100 or so, and set that to zero. I'm just going to just fly in past the camera and then go to the graph editor, and we want to be able to separate these channels. So click this separate dimensions button. Then we no longer need these two channels animated. We are only interested in the Z. We can grab that keyframe, ease it out. And in this one, we're going to maybe speed up at the beginning and then slow down as it gets towards the end. And then we could also have this, we can have it stop in this position. So keyframe the Y. And at the beginning though, let's have that a little bit higher. It's going to be more like that. And again, we could ease out that motion too. And because this is going to be quite close to the camera and you should be able to see some motion blur, enable motion blur for the layer, and then for the comp, you can see a little bit of motion blur. Back to the timeline view, click the U key, and then we got something like this. All right, so that's all for this tutorial. Really simple effect. Basically just introducing the displacement map and how you can use it with some simple screen glitch stock footage. This is, of course, by no means a final animation sequence, but you know, it's something you could definitely expand upon. So hope you enjoy that, and please subscribe for more videos. All right, thank you. Have a good day.